You've got your screen here and you've got the camera at the bottom. If we go onto grid, so by selecting this blue square, that should open up your grid software. It might take a moment or two. And then what we need to do is we need to go into settings in order to look at the calibration. So if you select these three lines at the top left of your screen, and then go into settings, what we should be able to do is then go down to access on the side. Into access and then eye gaze, and what we then get is a little menu. So the main thing that we need to do is to check the calibration. So that's this point here. So what we need to do is put the device in front of us so that your eyes and your face are in front of the screen. So I'll try and show you. Okay, so currently this is currently not picking up my eyes, so in this square it's saying no eyes detected. So what we need to do is reposition the device to enable this camera to be able to see my eyes looking at it. So I'm just going to try and do that now. Just to adjust the screen, make sure you keep hold of the screen as you're doing this. Okay, now I'm sat in front of it, you usually need to make sure to put it away. I'll show you in a second what that screen looks like once I've secured it, so that you can see when it's working correctly. When you are correctly positioned, this is what the screen should look like. So the face on the screen should be white, smiling, and in the centre of the screen. What you can then do is press calibrate, and you need to follow the dots on the screen with your eyes. So I'm just staring at each dot as it disappears. And it's important to notice that you don't need to move your head when you're doing this, so it's just purely your eye movements looking around the screen. You'll then get a score. So because they're all green, that means that that's calibrated fairly well. Sometimes that can differ, but it still would work fairly well for the client. So it's not always the case. If it's red, that means usually it's not a great calibration, but it might still works, it's still worth trying. You You can also do this improve calibration option, which will enable you to work on the calibration and see if it can pick you up a little bit better. So I then go back and we can adjust some other settings if we would like. So for example, you can do activation, and this activate after just means that it's going to take a little bit longer for you to have to look at an item before it would select. So it's important to have that at the right level, because if it's too fast, it can just select things really quickly and can be quite distracting and off-putting. Again, if you've got it a bit too long, it can be quite tiring because you're having to stare at things for longer in order to activate them.